Hello students, welcome to our next topic, that is dynamic programming. So today now we are going to introduce another algorithmic technique called as dynamic programming. So till now, if you remember what all the techniques we have studied, now we have started with brute force technique. So we have seen the divide and conquer, then we have seen decrease and conquer, we have seen greedy method, right? So today, now we are going to look into another very interesting technique and very powerful technique, which is called as dynamic programming. So now, if you remember the divide and conquer technique, what we have already discussed. So divide and conquer technique, it was used to solve the problems that can be divided into independent sub-problems. Right, so when a problem is given for us, now we were trying to solve this problem by dividing it into small number of sub problems, right? So small sub problems we are trying to do it, and all these sub problems were independent to each other, so that it was easy to solve one sub problem, and finally we were trying to say that the entire problem was solved. Now on the other hand, now what do you mean by dynamic programming? So now dynamic programming is one type of a technique or a strategy now that uses to solve the problems which are having dependent sub problems. Now here sub problems are dependent. Now that is the one important thing which you have to remember. That means the sub problems are small problems what you are dividing. So these sub problems are dependent on some other sub problems. Right, like say in some cases the sub problems are shared and they cannot be solved independently. So the sub problems are being shared, so that until and unless the another sub problem you solve, you cannot solve the current sub problem. Now in some cases, now even though we can solve the sub problems independently, so many of the calculations is repeated, so unnecessarily we will be trying to repeat many of the calculations, right? Now let us take an example. Now if you take an example of Fibonacci number, so you know what is a Fibonacci number. So we say that the Fibonacci number, it starts with 0 and 1, right? Now you have written already the simple programs for that. So the number starts with 0 and 1. Now what is the third number you are going to get in Fibonacci series? By adding these two previous numbers. So 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. Right? Now what is the next number you are going to generate? Next number will be 1 plus 1, that is 2. Right? So next, the third number, the next Fibonacci series number is obtained by adding these two previous numbers. 2 plus 1, 3. So like this, now you are going to generate Fibonacci number. Now if you are going to look into this problem, the nth Fibonacci number, now we can say recursively, now we can come up with a formula. What is that formula? Now f of n is equal to f of n minus 1 plus f of n minus 2. So that means if you want this number, now we have to add the previous two numbers, right? So f of n, if you want, like say, now this is the first number, second number, third number, fourth number, fifth number. Now assume this is the fifth number. Now you want f of 5. So f of 5 is equal to f of 4 plus f of 3. Right, 5 minus 1 is 4 and 5 minus 2 is 3. So you can obtain this number 3 by adding this number 2 and the number 1. So this is the formula, f of n minus 1 plus f of n minus 2, with the initial condition f of 0 is 0, that means first number is 0 and the second number is 1. Now here, now we try to solve the f of n minus 1 that will contain a term f of n minus 2 plus f of n minus 3. Now again, if you want to find this term f of n minus 1, so how do you get this? Again by adding its previous two numbers, right? Now that if you want to find f of n minus 1, then you have to subtract the first number of f of n minus 1 minus 1, that is f of n minus 2, and f of n minus 2 minus 1, f of n minus 3. So f of n and it's a sub problem, now we can say that these are dependent. So if you want to find this number, so it is dependent on previous two solutions. This is where now we are talking about the dynamic programming. Now when you look into this, Now, many of the times in dynamic, in certain problems where the sub-problems are dependent, now we try to calculate the sub-problems. Many of the times we waste a lot of our time because the solutions will be already calculated. The sub-problem solutions will be calculated, but still again we want to calculate. So what happens? We say that the solutions are overlapping. Now, overlapping means you might be getting a particular sub-problem which you have already solved it. So again, you need not solve. Just what you have to do, you have to get that answer. You have to get that solution of that particular sub-problem. So instead of solving this overlapping sub-problem again and again, now dynamic programming, it suggests solving each of the smaller sub-problem only once. Now what does the dynamic programming say? That now if you get these type of overlapping sub-problems, no need to solve it again and again. You can just solve it only once. But after solving each sub-problem, you keep recording the results. Now results are being recorded. That means results are being stored in a table. Now we try to create one table. So in dynamic programming, all the solutions you are going to solve by using the tables. So you are going to have one table, like say two-dimensional table, where you solve one by one sub problems and you keep the result, right? Say for example, now this is one sub problem, you have solved it and you store the result here. Now there is another sub problem, you solve it and store the result here. Now suppose say that if a new sub problem comes, now if you want to solve it, now if this solution is already solved, if it is there in your table, you need not solve it once again, right? What we can do, you just take that result. That is what the dynamic programming says. Clear? So now let us try to take the first example, that is finding the binomial coefficient. So you know binomial coefficient, what is that? So generally in your elementary classes you might have studied this binomial coefficient, that is NCR. So popularly many of the mathematicians write it as NCR. So what is the NCR factorial? You know the equation NCR is equal to N factorial, right? In mathematics this is how you are calculating, N factorial divided by N minus R factorial into R factorial. So N factorial divided by N minus R factorial into R factorial. So this is the formula for NCR factorial. Now we will try to solve this particular problem using dynamic programming. So now we know that binomial coefficient NC K, right? Instead of R, we are using K here. Now NCK is the number of combinations of K elements. What is that? So when you are looking into this binomial coefficient, now this is nothing but it is a number of combinations of K elements out of N elements. So you have N elements. Now from that, what are the various combinations of K elements? It is called as binomial coefficient. Now the binomial coefficient, now it can be obtained from a formula. Now if you look, this is our mathematical formula. What it says is that binomial coefficient formula, a plus b to the power of n is equal to n c 0 into a to the power of n plus n c 1 into a to the power of n minus 1 times b plus etc. If you take ith term, then n c I into a to the power of n minus I into b to the power of I plus etc. Nth term, n c n into a to the power of 0 into b to the power of n. If you look here, the first term NC0, next it is NC1, NCI, nth term is NCN. Now you take the second term here, A to the power of N, that is the first number is there, right? A to the power of N into B to the power of, here only 0, that right? So we don't have. When you go to the second here, A to the power of N minus 1. So from N, N minus 1, N minus 2, etc. up to when you go to the last term, you won't be having, it will be 0, right? It becomes 0. And b starts with b to the power of 1 here. So 1, b to the power of 1, 2, 3, etc. b to the power of 5 into b to the last term will be b to the power of n. Now this is the equation. Now in this equation, if we want to find the binomial coefficient, now what we are going to do is, now we try to take this NC0, NC1, etc. Now here we consider a recursive formula. Now what is that formula? Now nck is equal to n minus 1 ck minus 1 plus n minus 1 ck, such that where k lies between 0 to n. And so nck is equal to, how you find nck? So nck is equal to n minus 1 ck minus 1 plus n minus 1 ck. Right, say for example you want to find 4c2, so you want to find 4c2. So if you are going to use this formula, now 4c2, how you can write n minus 1, that is 4 minus 1, that will be 3, right? 4 minus 1 is 3. 3c k minus 1, k is 2 here, 2 minus 1 is 1 plus, right, again n minus 1, 4 minus 1 is 3. So it becomes now 3ck, k is 2. Now this is how we are going to use this. Now there are two formulas. Now nck equal to n minus 1 ck minus 1 plus n minus 1 ck, and if nc0, that is nc0 is equal to ncn is equal to 1. If the denominator, that is if k here is 0, here subscript if it is 0, irrespective of n, the answer will be 1. Right? So like say for example 4c0 means how much? 4c0 will be 1 because down you have got 0, that is kth term is 0, or 3c0 is 0, 2c0 is 0, sorry not 0, it is 1. Right? nc0 will be equal to 1. Similarly ncn. Say for example 4c4, so 4 and 4 here, n and k are same, right? So ncn will be equal to 1. So this is our formula for using the binomial coefficient. Now it is obvious that now in our the above relation, now it is a recurrence relation, right? It is a recurrence relation, so we have to compute all the small sub problems, so overlapping problems. Now how we are going to solve this? By using dynamic programming. So now here in our dynamic programming, in order to solve this, now we are going to construct a table, right? Already we told that we are going to construct a table here. So now this particular table has n plus 1 rows and k plus 1 column. Now you have to remember that now all the problems what you are going to consider in dynamic programming in this unit, and to solve every problem we are going to construct one two-dimensional table, such that now how many rows will be? Rows will be n plus 1. So you have to find nck, right? Like say for example we told 5c2, n is 5. 5 means you should have n plus 1 rows and k plus 1 column. Right, n plus 1 rows and k plus 1 column. Now this is what we are going to construct. Now what you are supposed to find? Now you are supposed to find nck, right? So nck. So what is the formula? Nck is equal to n minus 1 c. Here we have written k plus n minus 1 c k minus 1. Right? So this is our the formula. Now you see here, so we are going to construct a table. Now how many rows will be there? So this represents your k, right? This is your k value, and down it represents n value, right? So you have got n, so you should have n minus 1 rows. So it will be, so you start with 0. So when you start with 0 to n means one row is added. So n minus 1 rows, and how many columns? Now it columns also k plus 1 column. So you start with 0 till k, right? So here you are going to start with 0 to k, and here 0 to n. So now when you try to write it as a table form, so 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., k minus I, etc. up to k. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to kth term, last term will be n. Right? Now, you look into this particular table. Now, we said here in our formula, there is another equation, right? nc0, this one, nc0 is equal to ncn is equal to 1. That means, irrespective of this n value, if your k value is 0, the result is 1. Now let us see. So now k is what? 0 here. So this is n value, right? So n is 0, k is 0. So both n and k are same. So our second condition, n c n. So both are 0, 0, result will be 1. Now when you come to this particular thing, now what is n value? N value is 1 and k value is 0. Since n c 0, now you see here, now we have two cases, right? So what was that case? Now I will write it here. So what is the first case? N c 0, right? N c 0 or n c n. In both these cases, n c 0 or n c n, in both the cases, what is our answer? The result what you are going to get is 1. Directly we write it, we don't calculate it. Now you see here, now n is what here? This side is n, right? Now n is 1, k is 0. You can see here, n is 1, k is 0. So what is the result? Result will be 1. Now what about this? Now n is 1, k is also 1. So n is 1, k is 1, both are same, 1, 1. So the result is what? 1. Now whereas this higher order terms, right? Now this order terms, no, whenever you have to see that always n should be, this value should be less than this value, right? So now then otherwise you are not going to consider this particular entries. Now we can say these entries are into mark, that means you are not going to consider all these entries. So now if you fill that, if you look into these two terms, irrespective of n, c is 0. Now if you take your first column, what is the value of c? We are having 0. So whether the n is 0 or 1 or 2 or 3 etc. up to n, right? What is the result? C is 0. If c is 0, the answer is 1. So the first column, in order to solve, when you are solving a problem, the first column what we write? Now we write all this as 1. Right? And look here. Now if when n c n, that means now this n and k should be same. So 1, 1, so here the result is 1. Now what about 2, 2, the result is 1. 3, 3, the result is 1. Right? Now like this, if you expand for the n minus 1 term, so n minus 1 term, so plus k minus 1. So what is that? So this is the value. So n minus 1 k, c of k minus I. And the next term will be n minus 1 ck. So now our ncr factorial, when you are going to find the binomial coefficient of nck, now nck is equal to what? N minus 1 ck minus 1 plus n minus 1 ck. Now this is your final result. So now if you look into your dynamic programming, now this is how you are going to create the table, and the last value is our result. This is where the result comes. Now in order to calculate this, you have to completely fill this particular table, that is all cell. So here to get a particular cell value, now we will add the entry at the same column and the previous row, right? Now if you want to get this value, now we are going to add the entry at the same column, this is 1, and the entry at the previous row. So we add these two so that we will be getting the values. So now if you look into this particular diagram, now you can see that now here till here, from here till the k value, right? Now here all 1 you are having and here 1 you are having. Now you can assume that it looks like a triangle, right? It looks like a triangle for us. Now this is our Pascal triangle. If you remember the small programs which you have written in C, you used to write. So write a C program which gives the output like 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1, like that. Now this here in our entire table, till the kth element you can assume it looks like a triangle, and next it looks like a rectangle. Now you have to observe this, because when we go for analysis, this is very important for us. So now we will be having the two things which you are going to consider here, right? So next we will try to understand this particular binomial coefficient. That is how we are going to design an algorithm for this particular binomial coefficient. So now this is our the algorithm what we are going to write. So now we are going to compute the binomial coefficient in C k by using dynamic programming. Now what is the input? Non-negative integers n and k, right? Such that n should be greater than, always n should be greater than k. And the output what you are going to get, you are going to get the output nck. So if you remember this table, so the last entry of our table is our answer, right? So now we use two for loops. So for I equal to 0 to n, for j equal to 0 to minimum of I comma k. Now what we said, so always j value. Now if you consider I and j, so these are the two variables what we are using in our program. Now here what is our I and what is our j? So if you look into this table, right, now this is your j value and this is your I value, right? This is your j and this is your I, and always you have to see that this I value should be less, it should be, see, if you take this, it should be minimum of these two values. So if you consider here, now this value is greater than this, so we cannot consider that particular entry. So in order to remove that, now what we are considering here, now j value should go from 0 to minimum of I and k, minimum of I and k, so else we are not going to consider. So if it is minimum of I and k, so then we check the condition. If j is 0, that is what we told nc0, right? That was our first another one case. So if j is 0 or j and j is equal to k, or if this value and this value are same, in both the cases what will be the result? Result will be 1. So c of ij, the cell entry will be 1. Else what will be the cell entry? C of ij will be equal to c of I minus 1 comma j minus 1 plus c of I minus 1 j. This is nothing but the same formula we are writing. So right, so what we are writing, so if you want to find c of ij, right, nck is equal to, so how we can write it is c of I minus 1, c of I minus 1, right, c of I minus 1 and j minus 1 plus previous two terms you are going to add, so plus now c of I minus 1 and j, right? This is what the formula. So this is our formula we are implementing here, and we have two cases here. So one is when the j is 0, result is 1, or when j and k is both are same also, result is 1. So like this, now we try to build that entire table, and we are going to return nk. So we start from 0 till n we go, and k value j from minimum of I minus k. So that last value will be our result, right? So now you will understand better when we take up an example and when we try to see it. So now before going to the example, now we will look into the analysis of this particular thing. How we try to do the analysis. Now the complexity of this algorithm, now it depends on n and k. Now there are two inputs, one is n and another one is k, right? Now what is the basic operation here? The basic operation is addition, right? We are going to add the two numbers. Now we observe from the table that first k plus 1 row, the entries will look like a triangle. Now as we have seen, right, first k plus 1 row, the entries looks like a triangle, right? After that it looks like a rectangle. It looks like the entries looks like a rectangle. Afterwards it will be a rectangular in shape. So the number of additions differs. So in the first part additions, and in second part it differs from the first k plus 1 row and rest of n minus k row, where n minus k row means we get like a triangle. So now for each value of I and j in the algorithm, now we have exactly one addition, right? So we have one addition. Now what is that? So we can say time complexity, how we can calculate? Now, C equal to summation of I is equal to 1 to K and J is equal to 1 to I minus 1 of 1. Now, this is for what? For triangle, right? So, for the initial triangle plus summation K plus 1 to N, rest part after K, till K you have a triangle, so one addition. Now, after K, now again we are taking, right? It looks like a rectangle for us. So, for I is equal to K plus 1 to last value N and J is equal to 1 to K. So, now we have again the addition, right? Here the addition will be less, here the addition will be removed. So, now we use the same simple formulas which we have tried. So, we remove the first summation by using the formula upper bound minus lower bound plus 1. So, that is upper bound is I minus 1. So, I minus 1 minus lower bound is 1 plus 1, right? Similarly, second term we remove this summation upper bound K minus lower bound is 1 plus 1. So, in the next step we simplify this. So, here plus 1 and minus 1 cancels with each other, you will get I minus 1. Now, here these two cancels and you will get K, right? So, now outside we have another summation. Now, we will solve this. So, for I is equal to what? 1 to K, right? So, now we have two terms here, I minus 1. So, we bring the summation inside. So, first summation will be summation I is equal to 1 to K of I minus, again summation I is equal to 1 to K of 1 plus, now you have only one term here, so we'll write as it is. So, now here for I is equal to K plus 1, right? Now, here the term is K, but you are having I. So, K is what? It will be a constant. So, we will bring this constant outside. Now, this we will write 1. So, this can be written as K into 1, right? Because this is term is I. So, K is a constant. So, we bring this outside and we will write it as 1. So, now this is equal to, now summation I is equal to 1 to K of I. That means, if you start substituting value of this, so this will be 1 plus 2 plus 3 etc. up to K, right? It is nothing but summation, the standard formula 1 plus 2 plus 3 etc. up to N is equal to what you can write? N into N plus 1 by 2. Here instead of N we have K, so we will write K into K plus 1 by 2, right? So, minus, now this I, but this is 1, so only one constant is there, right? So, minus, we take it as K plus the K into, now here summation I equal to K plus 1 to N. So, we can use the formula upper bound is N minus lower bound minus K minus 1 plus 1, right? So, now again you can simplify these two terms. Now, when you simplify this, so this will be, you are going to get K of K minus 1 of K divided by 2 plus K into N minus K. You can simplify, it is very simple. When you simplify this, you get this. Now, further, when you try to simplify, now you can take K by 2 outside and you can remove this plus. You can combine these two terms by taking K by 2 as a common. So, K by 2 into K minus 1 plus 2K minus 2K. Right? So, now finally, now this is what we are going to get. And as N increases, so then this terms will be negligible for us and you can remove all the constants. So, we can say this is almost equal to N into K. So, the time complexity of a binomial coefficient is N times K, N or N into K. So, how many rows and how many columns, all that you are supposed to multiply. So, now this is the time complexity of your binomial coefficient. Clear? So, now we will try to consider an example and we will see how we are going to construct that particular table. Clear? So, now, so what was our formula? Now, what we have written? Now, C of I comma j is equal to C of I minus 1 comma j plus C of I minus 1 comma j minus 1. So, let us take an example. You want to find C of phi C3, right? Phi C3. So, what is N value? N is equal to 5 and R value is what? R equal to 3. R or K, right? Any either you can say call it as R or you can call it as K. So, now you have to construct a table. Now, you are going to draw a table. So now how many rows will be there? So we told that n plus 1 rows and k plus 1 columns will be there. So now if you consider this as n, right? So if you are getting confused, instead of r we'll consider this as k itself, right? So k plus 1 column. So now what is n value? 5. So you start with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 till 5, right? And what is k? 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. Clear? So we will first write this. So now what is our the formula? It says that so nc0 and ncn equal to 1, irrespective of n value. When your k is 0, so this is k, right? K is 0 here, first column k is 0, irrespective of value of n. So when k is 0, the result is 1. So in your entire first column we will write 1 1 1 1 1. Clear? Next, ncn also equal to 1. Ncn means n and k values are same. So 0 0 you get 1. What about 1 1? In this entry you will get 1. 2 2 we will write 1, and 3 3 we will write 1. Clear? Now the remaining above this one diagonal, if you look into this diagonal, above elements we are not going to consider. For that we are using this value. Now say for example, now I is equal to 0, j is equal to 0, right? Now I is 0 and j is 0. So we are at this. Now the j, it goes, when you go here one by one, when in the entire row when you are processing, now j should go from 0 to minimum of I comma k. This value is okay. Now after j is 0, next step what happens? J is incremented to 1. Now j becomes 1 here, right? Now when j is 1, now you have to use this condition. Now minimum of I is what? 0. And what is our k value? K value is 3. So 0 and 3, which is minimum? 0 is minimum, right? So j should go from 0 to 0. It cannot become 1. So since j has become 1 now, we come outside the loop. That means we are not looking into this entry. Similarly, here also we don't look, and here also we don't look, right? So now j loop is completed. You come outside, I becomes 1. So you go to the next row, I becomes 1 here. Now you are supposed to find, now this entry is already over, right? This entry is there. Now this entry is also there. Now when it goes to this entry, right, because I is 1, again you start with j. J starts with 0 and 1, etc., like this. Now here what happens? Minimum. Now we are crossing this, so we are not going to take this entry and this entry. Like this your for loop or the program is going to work. Now let us see that manually how we are going to solve. Now this is what right now we have done. So all the first column we have entered 0, and wherever this 0 0 is also 1, 1 1 is 1, and 2 1 is 1, and 3 1 is 1, and above this we have marked this dot. So now you have to fill this value, and here you are going to get your result. What you have to find 5c3, right? This cell is going to give us the answer. We want to calculate this. Now to do that, one by one, step by step we will do it. Now first we will find the value at this cell. Now what is this cell entry? It is 3 1, right? Now before this, so now this entry you have to find. This entry you are not done, right? So only this row, your column, you have made it as 1, and this diagonal we have marked it as 1. So now first you have to enter this row. This row will be empty now. Now what is this? C of 2 1, right? Now we will write C of 2 1. We have to calculate C of 2 1. Now C of 2 1 is equal to, we use this formula. So C of 2 comma 1, I comma j is equal to C of I minus 1 comma j. That is C of 2 comma 1, how you can write? C of 2 minus 1 comma 1 plus C of 2 minus 1 comma 1 minus 1. We use this formula. Clear? So the same formula we are using. Now instead of I j, here we are having 2 1. I is 2 here and j is 1 here. So use this formula. So now this will be equal to C of 2 minus 1 is how much? 1 plus comma and 1 as it is plus C of 2 minus 1 is 1 and 1 minus 1 is 0. Right? So now what is C of 1, 1? You check into your table, have you got already the solution of this subproblem? C of 1, 1. Now you can go first row, first column. So this is 1, first row, that is 1 and 1. Already we have the result. What is this result? 1. You take that result here, 1 plus C of 1, 0. 1, this is C of, right, this is 1, 0. You come here, now what is C of 1, 0? C of 1, 0 is how much? 1. So plus 1. So 1 plus 1 equal to 2. So C of 2 comma 1, we got 2. Enter this into your table here. Right? So next, we'll go to the next step. So now, you have to find the value here. What is this value? 3, 1. So you have to find C of 3, 1. So what is C of 3, 1? C of 3, 1 is equal to C of, we'll use this formula, right? So it will be C of 2 comma 1 plus C of 2 comma 0, which is equal to, now what is C of 2 comma 1? You see, do you have that in your answer? C of 2 comma 1, C of 2 comma 1, we calculated in our previous step here itself. What is that? 2. So we'll write 2 plus C of 2 comma 0. This is 2, this is 0. So C of 2, 0 is how much? 1. Here 1 is there. So 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. So now what we got? C of 3, 1 is equal to 3. So now we'll go to this 3. This is 1. Now in this place, what answer we got? We got 3. So we will write this table as 3. Right? Now we have to find this value. What is this value? 3, 2. So now here we are using C of 3, 2. Now C of 3, 2 equal to C of I minus 1. 3 minus 1 comma j plus C of 3 minus 1 comma 2 minus 1, because here we have I minus 1 comma j minus 1. We use that formula. Now this is equal to, we simplify this, 3 minus 1 is what? 2 comma 2 plus C of 3 minus 1 is 2, 2 minus 1 is 2. Now you see, this is equal to, do we have the solution to this? Check in your table, C of 2 comma 2. So this is 2, this is 2. So 2 comma 2 means what? This value. So 2 comma 2, yes, we have the solution. What is that solution? 1. So it is 1. Plus C of 2 comma 1. So 2, 1, 2 comma 1 is how much? 2. So 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. Now we got C of 3 comma 2 value is 3. Now we will go to this table. This is 3, this is 2. So C of 3 comma 2, how much we got? We got result as 3. So we will write it here. Clear? So now we'll go to the next row. So what you have to find? This value you are going to find. What is this? 4, 1. C of 4, 1. Similarly, same procedure we are using. Now C of 4, 1 is equal to how much? C of 4 minus 1, 1 plus C of 4 minus 1, 1 minus 1. So if you simplify this, will be equal to C of 4 minus 1 is 3 and this is 1 plus C of 3 comma 0. Now C of 3 comma 1. So 3, 1, what is the answer? 3. It is there in our table. You take that answer, 3. What is C of 3 comma 0? This is 3, 0. So 3, 0 is how much? 1. So you take it as 1. So 3 plus 1, 4. So we got the result for what? 4 comma 1. So this is 4, this is 1. Now this value we have calculated, now enter it as 4. Clear? So next we have to find C of 4 comma 2. Now C of 4 comma 2. Now C of 4 comma 2. Now you use the same method, right? When you use the same procedure, when you calculate C of 4 comma 2, how much you got? 6. So we will enter that in our table. So we will enter that in our table. So here what is the result we got? 6. See, in the examination, this is how you have to do it. You have to calculate it and write it, keep on filling your table here. So next what you have to find? 4 and 3. C of 4 comma 3. So the next step, now C of 4 comma 3. So C of 4 comma 3. So use the formula, simplify it, and what is the result we are going to get? We get 4 here. So C of 4 comma 3, value what we got? We got the value as 4. So enter it into your table. Right? Now the last row. So last row, for your, which value you have to calculate? 5 1. So C of 5 1. C of 5 1. So you are going to find C of 5 1, which value is 5 we got. Then you are going for C of 5 comma 2, which is 10, and C of 5 comma 3, also 10. So now these values you enter it into your table. So we are going to enter these values into our table. So what is the values we got? So this we got 5, that is C of 5 comma 1 we got 5, then C of 5 comma 2 we got 10, and C of 5 comma 3 we got 10. Right, now all the cells are been entered, so we will stop our algorithm and we are going to return this value. This is C of how much? 5 3. Right, so we are supposed to find 5 C 3. So what is the result? What is 5 C 3? The final answer. So at the end, therefore, now you can write the required answer. So therefore, so what is the answer you got? So C of 5 3. So C of 5 3 is how much? It is equal to 10. Right, now this is a the problem. Now what we have seen by using dynamic programming, finding the coefficient. Right, so now in the examination, so instead of 5 comma 3, they may give you any values, but you have to use the formula, and in this particular fashion, step by step you are going to calculate. See, like step by step you calculate each step, and whatever results you are going to get, enter it into your table, and once this entire table is constructed, the last value is which gives you the answer. So this is what dynamic programming says. Right, so now we have used this particular problem, finding the coefficient of binomial coefficient using our dynamic programming. So the sub problems what we are solving here, one by one sub problem, now it depends on the previous problem. That is why we say so the sub problems are dependent on the previous solutions. Every time instead of calculating, what we do, whenever you keep on solving the sub problems, whatever result we get, we enter it into a table and we use that previous result only, such that now we can reduce our the problem in the time when you are going to calculate our problem. So this is about the first example what we have considered under dynamic programming, that is finding the binomial coefficient. Clear? So in the next class, now we will take up another example which is called as the Warshall's algorithm. So in our next class, now we will be looking into our Warshall's algorithm, and we'll see for what purpose it is being used and how we are going to solve that by using the dynamic programming. So you just practice another one to take another one or two simple program problem for binomial coefficient and try to work it manually and by using that simple formula. Okay, so we will wind up this session here. So if you have any doubt, so you can just drop a mail in the classroom. So thank you for listening. Bye bye. Take care. Bye.